Hi dear students, welcome to this class where we will be talking about heart diseases in pregnancy. Cardiac diseases in pregnancy are important because cardiac patients require intensive monitoring during pregnancy and during the delivery, that is both in the antenatal period and intrapartum period. Before going to the cardiac diseases in pregnancy, let us see what are the normal findings, normal physiological findings or changes in cardiovascular system during pregnancy. What are the normal physiological changes in pregnancy? Number one, pulse rate increases. So every patient will become tachycardic in pregnancy, mostly during the time of delivery pulse rate increases. So pulse rate increases, once pulse rate is increases, I told you that systolic blood pressure will also increase because systolic blood pressure is directly proportional to the pulse rate. Then peripheral resistance decreases because the blood vessels are dilating, because trophoblastic invasion has taken place into the blood vessels to decrease the blood pressure. So peripheral resistance decreases, so the diastolic blood pressure decreases in pregnancy. So basically your systolic and diastolic, the gap increases because diastolic blood pressure is decreasing, systolic blood pressure has increased a bit. So basically this gap is called the pulse pressure. So pulse pressure increases. So difference between systolic and diastolic blood pressure increases in pregnancy. Coming to the heart sounds. Okay, S1, that is the first heart sound, is very prominent and split. First heart sound is prominent and split in pregnancy. It is very largely heard. Okay, the second heart sound is normally heard. But if there is splitting of second heart sound, that is A2 P2 ka splitting ho raha hai, then it is pathological. Okay, third heart sound is normally not heard. In non-pregnant state, third heart sound is not heard. But in pregnancy, it is heard. Pregnancy, it is present. Okay. So third heart sound is because when there is hypervolemic circulation, when the blood is more than the blood, when they enter the ventricles from the aorta, atria, they are entering the ventricles. So then when there is a sound of the blood hitting the ventricles, that makes the third heart sound. Also read your cardiology notes, ek bar padh lena before reading this cardiac disease in pregnancy, so that your concept is much more clear. Okay, so third heart sound is present and prominent in pregnancy. Apart from that, coming to murmurs. Okay, some type of murmurs are physiologically heard in pregnancy. All pregnant patient will be having the murmur. One is continuous hemic murmurs are found in all patients over the tricuspid area. Now what is the tricuspid area? Tricuspid area is left, second and third intercostal space. Okay, so if this is the sternum, then the first, second intercostal space. So the second intercostal space in the left, just left, will be your tricuspid area. So there you will find a continuous hemic murmur, and continuous hemic murmur is because of hemodilution and volume overload. The second murmur which is normally heard is ejection systolic murmur. This is also found normally in the both in the aortic area as well as in the pulmonary area, and it starts from more than 10 to 12 weeks period of gestation and it continues till term. Okay, so this is also because there is increase in volume overload or blood overload. So two types of murmurs are normally heard. Apart from that, you have slight cardiomegaly in pregnancy. Because of the volume overload, the heart expands in size. Okay, so in ECG, if we do, then we get some cardiomegaly and left axis deviation. Left axis deviation is normal. Okay, so ECG left axis deviation is also normal. So these are the physiological changes in heart and cardiovascular system that you find. Also in cardiovascular system, remember that your plasma volume increases much more. Plasma volume increases by 40 to 50%, whereas your hematocrit increases by 30 to 40%. Okay, so jitna hematocrit bar raha hai, jitna RBCs bar raha hai, usse bhi zyada plasma bar raha hai. So that is why there is hemodilution of blood. Hemodilution of blood and a bit of anemia is common in pregnancy. So agar females mein 12 grams per deciliter ka cutoff lete for anemia, in pregnancy the cutoff reduces to 11 grams per deciliter. 11 se niche hum bolte hai patient ko mild anemia hai. So these are the normal findings of cardiovascular system in pregnancy. Once we have known the normal findings, now let us see ki humai kya kya signs and symptoms ho sakte hai which indicates heart disease during pregnancy. Okay, these are Metcalfe's criteria. Metcalfe's criteria is there for diagnosing heart disease in pregnancy. So what are the signs and symptoms with which patient will present? These are Metcalfe's criteria. First, coming to symptoms. Symptoms are what the patients are saying. Okay, number one, patient can say paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, means patient ko raat mein so jaati hai, subah subah early morning uth ke usko dyspnea hota hai. This is because there is pulmonary edema. Pulmonary edema jo ho jata hai, agar thoda thoda fluid hai, then it will remain in the basal part of the lungs. So in during the daytime when she is sitting and when she is standing or walking, she will not have any dyspnea. The moment she lies down at night, when the lungs are lie down in supine position, then this fluid will start filling in entire lungs. Wo pura lungs mein aa jayenge in sleeping position. So it will take hours to come to this position. So early in the morning patient ko dyspnea hoga and patient will feel breathless. So this is paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea and this is very characteristic of heart disease. उसके बाद धीरे 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 जब फ्लूइड पूरा लंग्स में भर जाता है इन सीवियर हार्ट डिजीज, देन पेशेंट विल हैव ऑर्थोपनिया. ऑर्थोपनिया लेटने पे तुरंत उसको डिस्निया हो जाता है. दिस इज ऑर्थोपनिया. दिस सेज द सीवियरिटी इट हैज़ इंक्रीज. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट पेशेंट विल हैव नॉक्टर्नल कफ. नॉक्टर्नल कफ हो जाएगा. कफ होगा एंड एसोशिएटेड विद दैट पेशेंट विल हैव पिंक फ्रॉथी स्पूटम. पिंक फ्रॉथी स्पूटम. These are very much specific of heart disease. That is mostly specific of MS, that is mitral stenosis ke ye symptoms hain. Iske alawa patient can have chest pain, patient can have hemoptysis in the form of pink frothy sputum. Hemoptysis ho jayega when the blood vessels are rupturing because of cough, and then patient can have syncope. So these are the symptoms with which patient will present. Now what are the signs with which we can elicit in a patient of heart disease in pregnancy? So the signs are, number one, patient ka agar JVP dekhenge to jugular venous pressure will be increased in the neck because of hyperdynamic circulation and right heart failure. Patient will have clubbing, patient will have cyanosis, because these are more in cyanotic heart diseases like tetralogy of Fallot and all those things. Then there can be systolic murmur should be more than grade 3, that is grade 4 and above. More than equal grade 4 will be abnormal, but any grade of diastolic murmur is always abnormal. Remember, diastole mein kabhi murmur nahi hona chahiye pregnancy mein. Any grade of diastolic murmur, thoda sa bhi agar diastolic murmur hai, then this is pathological in pregnancy. Whereas systolic murmur, I have already told you that ejection systolic murmur ho raha hai normally bhi pregnancy mein, but that is of low grade. That was of low grade, that is grade 1, 2 and 3 murmurs are physiological. But systolic murmur more than equal grade 4, basically there are 6 grades of murmur, so try to read it. Okay, so grade 4, 5 and 6 murmurs are pathological इफ इट इज सिस्टोलिक, एंड डायस्टोलिक मर्मर कोई भी ग्रेड का हो वो हमेशा पैथोलॉजिकल होता है. ठीक है. देर कैन बी एरिथमियाज. एरिथमियाज कैन बी फाउंड व्हेन पेशेंट विल हैव योर ब्लड क्लॉट्स ओके इन द एट्रिया. सो दैट विल लीड टू एरिथमिया इफ द एट्रिया आर नॉट एबल टू contract. Okay, then in ECG what are the abnormalities which you get? There can be T wave inversion, there can be T wave inversion, there can be biatrial enlargement because of volume overload, and there can be arrhythmias. Okay, arrhythmias can be found. And persistently split second heart sound. Splitting of second heart sound, I had already told कि splitting of first heart sound होता है, but splitting of second heart sound is not physiological. So splitting of S2 is also pathological. Okay, so these are the signs and symptoms which you get in patient of heart disease, and this criteria is called Metcalfe's criteria. अगर exam में पूछेंगे तो you can write it. Okay. Next, coming to some of the MCQ questions which generally come to you is, what is the most common cardiac disease which you find in pregnancy? तो उसमें भी depend करता है what whether it is congenital heart disease or it is an acquired valvular disease. So most common acquired valvular disease is mitral stenosis in pregnancy. Most common congenital heart disease is atrial septal defect ASD in pregnancy. मोस्ट कॉमन साइनोटिक हार्ट डिजीज़ कौन सा है? मोस्ट कॉमन साइनोटिक हार्ट डिजीज़ इन प्रेगनेंसी ऑल्सो इज फैलोट स्टेट्रोलॉजी. ओके, टेट्रोलॉजी और फैलोट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन साइनोटिक हार्ट डिजीज विच इज फाउंड. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट कमिंग टू द सेकेंड क्राइटेरिया इज योर क्लार्क्स क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ हार्ट डिजीज इन प्रेगनेंसी. क्लार्क्स क्लासिफिकेशन. Clark's classification consists of four categories. Okay, basically four categories of heart diseases in pregnancy. Category 1, category 2, category 3 and category 4. Okay, category 1 is the safest, that is the least risk, in pregnancy. And this Clark's classification has now been adopted by WHO. So nowadays they will ask you WHO category of heart disease in pregnancy. Okay, so the mortality rate is very low, it is only 0 to 1%. Okay, type 1 group 1 has minimal risk of mortality of 0.1%. okay, so isme aapke kya kya aa jata hai? Isme aapke aa jate hai patent ductus arteriosus, pulmonary stenosis, theek hai, and your mitral valve prolapse. Okay, so basically these are the things which come. Okay, and your corrected ASD, VSD, all these things come. So if they are lesions are corrected, अगर valvular diseases आप correct कर देते हो, ASD, VSD, PDA, तो ये सारे आ जाएंगे आपके category 1 में. Then coming to category 2. Category 2 consists of uncorrected ASD, VSD and all those things come in category 2. All the uncorrected lesions whereby you are not able to, you have not done any surgery, so these all come in category 2. Now it is very important to see ki whether it is in which category, because the mortality rate of the disease keeps on increasing when you go to more and more severe ones. Okay, so coming to like category 2, you also have your repaired tetralogy of Fallot. If it is repaired tetralogy of Fallot, then you come, this is category 2. Or if patient are having arrhythmias, then also it is category 2. Okay, coming to category 3. Category 3 is whenever there is HOCM. HOCM is hypertrophic obstructive cardiomyopathy, or any patient who is having mechanical valves. Means किसी का artificial valve लगा हुआ है, then mechanical valves come in category 3. Mechanical valves are category 3. or if patient is having any repaired coarctation of aorta. Repaired coarctation of aorta is category 3. So remember, if this is unrepaired coarctation of aorta, तब वो category 4 में चला जाएगा, because coarctation of aorta is associated with a lot of mortality. But once you have repaired, it comes in category 3. Then your Marfan syndrome is associated with dilation of the aortic root. So aorta का जो origin होता है, aortic origin, that becomes very much dilated, and then aortic walls become very thin in patients of Marfan syndrome. So अगर volume overload होता है तो aortic dissection is very common. aorta के जो walls है, they are very thin. तो अगर प्रेशर बढ़ता है तो एओटा फट जाता है, इजीली फट जाता है इन पेशेंट्स ऑफ मार्फन सिंड्रोम. सो एओटा का जो डायमीटर है, दैट इज़ अ प्रोग्नोस्टिक मार्कर कि एओटिक डिसेक्शन होगा कि नहीं. सो इन मार्फन सिंड्रोम वेयर द एओटिक वाल्व एरिया, दैट इज़ द डायलिटेशन इज, इफ़ इट इज़ मोर देन 50 millimeter, दैट इज़ मोर देन 5 centimeter, देन इट इज़ इन कैटेगरी 4. Whereas if it is between Marfan syndrome with aortic valve area 45 to 50 mm will be in category 3, 45 to 50 mm will be in category 3. Okay. Sorry, I made a mistake. Just correcting it. 1 minute. Marfan syndrome, once it is Marfan syndrome and the diameter is more than 45 mm, 4.5 centimeter, then it is category 4. Whereas if it is between 40 to 45 mm, then it is category 3, Marfan syndrome. Okay. But if the aortic valve area, if it is bicuspid aortic valve, and the valve area, the diameter is between, if it is more than 50 mm, then it is category 4. But bicuspid aortic valve, if it is 45 to 50 mm, it is category 3. So remember, bicuspid aortic valve mein valve diameter is for 5 mm more than Marfan syndrome with the cutoff is taken. Apart from that, category 4 mein aapke aur kya kya cheez aata hai? Eisenmenger syndrome. What is Eisenmenger syndrome? Eisenmenger syndrome is when there is reversal of shunt. Reversal of shunt means if there is, suppose between your right atrium and left atrium, there is a shunting present. So initially what happens, left atria ka jo pressure hai, that is always more than right atria. So basically blood will go from left atria to right atria in normal condition. So pure blood is mixing with impure blood, so this is not something which is very dangerous. But dheere dheere kya hoga, right heart mein there will be congestion and blood will keep on accumulating. So after some time the right heart pressure increases and there is reversal of shunt. Now blood goes from the right atria to the left atria. So there is mixing of deoxygenated blood with the oxygenated blood, and then patient will start having cyanosis. This is called Eisenmenger syndrome. Eisenmenger syndrome is very dangerous because patients die just after delivery. Okay, because of the reversal of shunt, patient becomes cyanosed. So Eisenmenger syndrome is category 4. Okay. So severe coarctation of aorta which is unrepaired, Marfan syndrome with dilatation of aortic diameter more than 45 mm, bicuspid aortic valve more than 50 mm, Eisenmenger syndrome, severe mitral stenosis when the valve area is less than 1 cm². Okay, severe mitral stenosis, and then severe symptomatic aortic stenosis, these are all category 4, and they are associated with more than 50% maternal mortality. So pregnancy is contraindicated in category 4. Pregnancy is contraindicated in category 4. So if patient comes to us in first trimester or second trimester, we advise them to go for medical termination of pregnancy. This is on maternal ground, maternal health risk. Maternal health ko bachane ke liye hum MTP करा देते हैं, but patient if it is not willing for MTP, then you have to monitor the pregnancy throughout the gestational age. Throughout gestational age, you have to monitor pregnancy. So when do you admit which patient? Which category of patient, when do you admit? If it is category 1, then you admit the patient at 36 weeks and go for elective induction of labor at around 38 weeks. At around 38 to 39 weeks, you go for elective induction of labor so that you can plan the delivery properly. In category 2 and category 3, you try to admit the patient at the beginning of the third trimester. That is, at around 30 weeks, you try to admit the patients so that any complication can be monitored in the hospital. But category 4, you have to admit the patient throughout pregnancy. Admit her in ward throughout pregnancy, because these patients are very high risk and you have to first counsel them for MTP, because pregnancy is contraindicated. If they are not willing for termination of pregnancy and they are wanting to keep the baby, then you have to admit the patient throughout pregnancy and monitor her vitals and go for elective LSCS. You have to go for cesarean section, because normal delivery cannot be allowed in such patients, because volume overload will be much high and then patient has a very high rate of maternal mortality if they are if patient is allowed to deliver. Okay, now heart disease termination is advised in all such patients which are category 4. So remember, this is an important question which will be asked, ki when does termination of pregnancy is advised, what are the conditions in which termination of pregnancy is advised. Marfan syndrome with aortic valve diameter more than 45 mm, coarctation of aorta, Eisenmenger syndrome, all the patients who have NYHA category 3 and 4. NYHA category 3 and 4. What do you mean by 3 and 4? Means patient is having dyspnea at rest. Dyspnea even at rest. Patient ko rest pe hi shortness of breath ho raha hai. These all patients have to go for termination of pregnancy. Otherwise, they have to go for elective LSCS. Okay. Next, coming to CARPREG scoring. CARPREG scoring means cardiac disease in pregnancy scoring. So CARPREG scoring is a scoring system which is used for prediction of cardiac events during pregnancy. Okay, so there are 4 things which are tested. Okay, so you have a mnemonic, NOPE, NOPE. NOPE is the mnemonic which is used. N stands for NYHA. So NYHA grade 3 and 4. We know 3 and 4 are indications for termination of pregnancy. So if patient is NYHA grade 3 and 4, then you say ki patient ko CARPREG scoring mein le lenge. The second criteria is O. O stands for obstructive lesions in the left heart. Obstructive lesions in left heart means left heart failure. Left heart failure kaise pata chalega? When mitral valve area is less than 2 cm square or aortic valve area is less than 1.5 cm square or peak left ventricular outflow. Peak left ventricular outflow tract gradient is more than 30 millimeters of mercury. It means ki left heart ko bahut pressure lagana pad raha hai aorta ke andar blood push karne ke liye, because there is volume overload. If any of these criteria is present, it tells that obstruction is present in left heart. So this is one criteria. P stands for prior cardiac events. History mein puchoge ki patient ko prior koi heart failure to nahi tha, congestive heart failure, prior history of arrhythmias, okay, or any transient ischemic attacks, or prior history of stroke. Any of these histories present, then prior cardiac event is positive. And the fourth is E, that is ejection fraction of less than 40%. Ejection fraction of less than 40% means blood is not able to be pumped forward. So if these criteria are present, then we say we take it in car break. Okay. So if the risk is, if the total score is zero, means none of the NOPE is present, total score is zero, then risk of cardiac complications, risk of cardiac complications is 5%, cardiac complications in 5% in the pregnancy. If the score is 1, then the cardiac complications are 30%. But if the score is 2, 3 or 4, okay, either of it will be score given 1 score, 1, 1, 1, 1. The total score, maximum score will be 4. So if it is 2, 3 and 4, then the risk is 75% during pregnancy, means risk of cardiac complications and risk of death. Okay, so these are the scorings that you do. Next question, which is important and comes to you, is how do you manage a case of cardiac disease in pregnancy? What is the management of heart disease in pregnancy? So management starts from the antepartum period, antenatal period. When the patient comes to you, what precautions do you start and what do you start? So basically in the antepartum period, the time of hospitalization, I have told you, in category 1, we hospitalize at 36 weeks. Category 2 and 3, you hospitalize at the beginning of this third trimester, that is at somewhere around 28 to 30 weeks. And category 4, you admit throughout the pregnancy. Sometimes some people say that category 3, maybe you can keep throughout pregnancy, you can tell them, okay. So this is what is done. In the antepartum period, also remember that patient should have regular OPD visit, whereby we will get an obstetrician's visit plus a cardiologist visit also. Cardiologist will also monitor the patient's vitals. Vitals will be monitored, saturation will be monitored in every visit, and then you have to do fetal echo also, fetal echocardiography. Because many of the heart diseases are congenital. If mother is having congenital heart disease, ASD, VSD, then it may be transmitted to the baby also. So get a fetal echo done at 20 to 22 weeks period of gestation. Paanchve mahine mein, 20 to 22 weeks mein, get a fetal echo also done to the patients. Okay. These are the antepartum management. Anytime patient is having shortness of breath or NYHA category 3 and 4 ho jata hai, then you admit the patient right away and then we have to terminate the pregnancy. Coming to intrapartum management. Intrapartum management means how will you do, what management will you do when the patient is in labor. So first, patient should be allowed to go into spontaneous labor. Always spontaneous labor is better than induced labor, because we all want ki NVD ho jaye patient ko agar category 1 and category 2 lesion hai WHO ka. But if it is category 3 and 4, we try to go for cesarean section. If induction of labor has to be done, then do a planned induction of labor with vaginal prostaglandin E2. Prostaglandin E2 is very safe, that is dinoprostone gel. Dinoprostone gel se induction karna is very safe in heart disease pregnancy. Okay, induction can be done mostly in the morning time mein induce karte, because we want ki patient din din mein deliver ho jaye when cardiologist is also there in front of us. Then trial of labor is contraindicated in patients of category 4 heart disease, WHO category 4 heart disease. You should not give trial of labor. Patient should be kept in propped up position, when patient is in labor. Theek hai, supine position mein nahi letana hai, patient will have shortness of breath. So propped up position will be kept, and patient should be given oxygen by face mask, where you give 5 to 6 liters of oxygen per minute. This will help in providing good oxygenation to the body, and it will also prevent fetal distress. So oxygen will be given. you have to restrict IV fluids. Restrict IV fluids, because if you give more and more of IV fluids, then there will be volume overload and heart failure, congestive heart failure will occur, pulmonary edema will occur. So restrict IV fluids at less than 75 ml per hour. Even if you give IV fluids, then hamesha, this is very important and questions come. This are areas of question. So 75 ml per hour se kam IV fluid dena hai. Vaginal delivery is always the preferred modality, and in vaginal delivery you have to cut short second stage of labor. Second stage of labor, this you all know ki second stage of labor jab ho raha hai to patient valsalva karti hai, and agar patient valsalva karenge, pressure lagayenge, to patient ka volume overload ho jayega and chances of heart failure is very much high in second stage. So you have to cut short second stage of labor. You have to use prophylactic forceps delivery, forceps or vacuum, that is ventus delivery has to be done in patients of heart disease. Whenever she is fully dilated, you have to do this. And when patient is going and patient is in second stage of labor, usi samay patient ko injection furosemide is given. Injection furosemide, or which is also called market name hai Lasix. Lasix dete hai, kitna dete hai? 10 mg. 10 mg is equivalent to 1 ml. 1 ml of Lasix intravenous bolus dose dete hai, because this is a diuretic and wo urine output badha dega and urine se sara fluid overload nahi hoga, wo nikal jayega urine se. So basically Lasix has to be given just when the patient is going for delivery, then you have to give Lasix, because jaise hi aapka uterus contract ho jayega, baby out ho jayega, uterus contract ho gaya, to sara blood aapke body mein aa jayega, systemic circulation mein aa jayega and heart mein aake heart mein pressure lagayega and wo congestive heart failure ho jayega. Taki wo blood aake heart ke paas na aaye, wo jaldi se urine mein nikal jaye. So we give the diuretic when patient is going for delivery. Now the best painkiller, the best pain management for patients of heart disease is epidural analgesia. Epidural analgesia. So you give analgesic agents, okay, propofol or something like that, you give in the epidural space. So epidural analgesia is very safe and patient does not have any pain. Why pain relief is very important? Very, very important question. Pain nahi hone dena hai heart disease wale patients ko. Because if there is pain, then there will be tachycardia. Pain ho jayega to tachycardia ho jayega. And tachycardia ho jayega to heart rate increase ho jayega. So heart rate increase ho jayega, to more and more time patient will be in systole, heart systole mein rahega. Tachycardia ho jayega, to systole mein rahega and your diastolic duration will decrease. Diastolic duration will decrease. Diastolic duration agar decrease ho jayega, to heart gets perfusion. The coronary vessels supply blood to the heart during the diastole. तो अगर डायस्टोल का ड्यूरेशन कम हो जाएगा तो हार्ट को ब्लड सप्लाई कम पहुंचेगा. हार्ट को ब्लड सप्लाई कम पहुंचेगा तो देर विल बी कार्डियक इश्चीमिया. कार्डियक इश्चीमिया विच विल लीड टू हार्ट फेलियर. सो बेसिकली हमें टैकीकार्डिया नहीं होने देना है, तो पेशेंट को पेन बिल्कुल नहीं होने देना है. पेन हो जाएगा तो डायस्टोल कम हो जाएगा एंड पेशेंट विल गो इनटू कार्डियक इश्चीमिया. सो वी हैव टू रिड्यूस द pain sensation to the mother. So best is to give epidural analgesia. If epidural analgesia is not possible, then you have to give IV morphine to the patients. Morphine is a very good analgesic. So IV morphine is US FDA approved for heart disease pregnancy wale patients mein. Okay. Anesthesia during LSCS or cesarean section, preferred mode is also epidural analgesia. Okay. Now the thing is that once patient delivers, then you go for postpartum management. Postpartum management is also very important, third stage, because you have to prevent PPH. These patients are very prone to have postpartum hemorrhage. So what you do is you start oxytocin. Oxytocin 10 international units IV have to be given and you can repeat it 4 times. You can repeat it. Once oxytocin agar kaam nahi karta hai, next you give tablet misoprostol. Tablet misoprostol. So what is contraindicated in heart disease patients? Contraindicated is your methergine. methergine, or the drug, the second drug, which is methyl ergometrine, basically methyl ergometrine is contraindicated in patients of heart disease. Why? Because methergine will give a very tetanic contraction to the uterus. Uterus achanak se bahut zyada contract kar jata hai, and there is volume of blood which will be shifted to the heart and there will be heart failure. So achanak se uterus ko contract nahi karana hai, kyunki sara blood heart mein chala jayega and heart failure ho jayega. So you have to prevent that. That is why methyl ergometrine or methergine is contraindicated. What are the other conditions in which methergine is contraindicated? Very, very important. Methergine, contraindications to methergine are four disorders. Always remember. Number one, I have told heart disease. Heart disease mein methergine nahi dena hota hai. Number two is severe preeclampsia. If a patient is severe preeclampsia, she is already in pulmonary edema and volume overload ho rakha hai, BP zyada hai. So if you give methergine to these patients, also in patients of eclampsia, if you give methergine, then patient will land up, uska BP aur shoot up ho jayega, and patient will land up into pulmonary edema and patient will die. So you should not give. The third is Rh negative pregnancy. Rh negative pregnancy mein bhi methergine nahi dena hai, because if you give methergine, it will increase the fetomaternal hemorrhage and maternofetal hemorrhage, and so more chances of Rh isoimmunization in next pregnancy. And the fourth is twin pregnancy. Twin pregnancy mein after delivery of first twin, T1 ki delivery ho gaya and you have given methergine, T2 to andar hi hai, ab kya karega, uterus achanak se contract kar jayega and T2 andar hi reh jayega, usko nikalna bahut mushkil ho jayega, T2 phas jayega andar. So after both twins are delivered, then only you can give methergine. After the first twin is delivered, you cannot give methergine. So these are the four contraindications of methergine, you should remember. Once patient has delivered and you have monitored for PPH, now you will advise the patient for contraception. Contraception advice has to be given. So contraception advice, the temporary method of choice. You can have two methods, temporary and permanent. Temporary method of choice is barrier method, barrier contraception or condoms, because they are safe, they have no side effect. Heart disease pe koi side effect nahi hai. Theek hai. What permanent method? Coming to the permanent method. Permanent method mein what is important is, if the mother is all right, mother ka health is all right, then you can go for tubal sterilization. Tubal sterilization. Tubal sterilization ke liye mother ko hame anesthesia dena padega. So patient's physical condition should be all right. But if the mother is having a decompensated heart disease, hame anesthesia nahi de sakte hai, patient is very in category 4 heart disease, then hum kya karenge, hum husband ko bolenge vasectomy karane ke liye. Husband can go for vasectomy, because husband vasectomy can be done, husband is not having any heart disease. So this is important, very important concept. Agar permanent contraception chahiye, mother ka agar compensated heart disease hai, then only we can go for sterilization. Otherwise, if mother is having decompensated heart disease, advise the husband to go for vasectomy. What are the contraindications? Which contraceptions are contraindicated in heart disease patient? Number one, OC pills. OC pills are contraindicated because the progesterone component will lead to thrombosis, and there will be thromboembolic event. So that is why it is not given. The second one is IUCDs, like copper T, multi-load, they are also contraindicated because chances of intrauterine infection increases. Heart disease wale patients are very fragile, and if there is infection, then patient will be at very much risk of having disease. Okay, so prognosis of this patients depends upon ki what is the category of the heart disease. Okay, now some of the important questions which are asked is, mitral stenosis is the most common disease, you all know. So what is the best management for mitral disease is balloon mitral valvotomy. Okay, valvotomy is done. But if the valves are calcified, if the mitral valves are calcified, then calcified valves mein valvotomy karna bahut mushkil hota hai, balloon dalna mushkil hota hai. then you go for mitral valve replacement. Mitral valve replacement, okay, is done in patients who have calcified valves. अगर regurgitation है, जैसे mitral regurgitation, aortic regurgitation, तो उनमें तो valvotomy नहीं कर सकते, then you have to go for direct valve replacement. Now the question is, what is the best time of valvotomy or valve replacement in pregnancy? The best time is between 14 to 18 weeks of pregnancy. 14 से 18 हफ्ते के बीच, second trimester के initial part में, you can go for the surgeries, okay? Then septic abortion is the most common cause of tricuspid valve. So if somebody tells you ki right heart valves are affected, then what is the most common cause is septic abortion. क्योंकि अगर septic abortion होगा, अगर abortion कर रहा है कोई, तो abortion से क्या होगा, सबसे पहले all the bacteria will come to the inferior vena cava के through it will come to the right atrium, and then right atrium से your mitral valve will be affected first, tricuspid valve will be affected first, okay? So tricuspid valve will be affected in septic abortion. The second most common cause after septic abortion is IV drug abuse. If somebody is doing IV drug abuse, then also the drug is injected into the veins. So the drugs, all the bacteria will come to the inferior vena cava first, and then it will come to the right atrium, and it will come to the tricuspid valve. Okay. So these are the things. Okay. And what is rule of five? Next comes the question, what is rule of five? Rule of five is there in heart disease in pregnancy. What are the most dreaded times, most complicated times of heart disease in pregnancy? Most of the complications hota hai rule of 5 ke aaspaas. So first hota hai at around 5 weeks of pregnancy. At 5 weeks of pregnancy, all the hemodynamic changes in pregnancy, hemodynamic changes of heart disease start. So jab starting hota hai, hemodilution start hota hai, tab patient ka heart failure ho sakta hai. नेक्स्ट है कि हीमोडायनेमिक चेंजेस आर एट पीक एट 32 वीक्स. 32 वीक्स पे हीमोडायनेमिक चेंजेस आर एट देयर पीक. तो सबसे ज़्यादा हीमोडाइल्यूशन रहता है, तो वॉल्यूम ओवरलोड होके हार्ट फेलियर हो सकता है. तो 3+2 इज अगेन इक्वल टू 5. सो अगेन आ गया आपका 5. देन द थर्ड टाइम इज 5 मिनट्स आफ्टर डिलीवरी. Because 5 minutes after delivery, अगर आपने delivery के time पे Lasix या furosemide नहीं दिया है, then 5 minutes के अंदर सारे uterine blood आ जाएगा heart में, and there will be volume overload, and patient will have congestive heart failure 5 minutes after delivery. उसके बाद 5 days after delivery, 5 days after delivery, rate of infection is very high, because if the uterus has subinvoluted, then puerperal period hai, agar aapne acha antibiotics nahi diya hai, then patient will have infective endocarditis bahut high hota hai in the first week of delivery, that is first 5 days after delivery, infective endocarditis high hota hai. And then comes 5 months after delivery. Till 5 months after delivery, you can have PPCM. What is PPCM? Peripartum cardiomyopathy. It is just like your DCMP. DCMP is dilated cardiomyopathy. Dilated cardiomyopathy means, jab aap echo karaoge, aapke global hypokinesia and global dilatation of all the heart chambers are found. Matlab sare heart chambers aapka globally dilated milega. This is called DCMP. But when DCMP occurs during pregnancy, that is in the last one month of pregnancy, plus 5 months postpartum. This is the entire total 6 months ke andar, agar delivery ke 6 months ke andar, means 1 month prior to delivery and 5 months after delivery. In this period, if somebody is having global dilatation of the heart chambers, that is DCMP, then this is termed as PPCM, peripartum cardiomyopathy. Peripartum cardiomyopathy can occur up to 5 months after delivery. So this is rule of 5, which is very, very important. Now coming to infective endocarditis, a word about infective endocarditis. Infective endocarditis you all read in your medicine classes, so try to revise from there properly. You have a Duke's criteria for diagnosis. I'm not going into much detail, just refer to your cardiology classes. Duke's criteria may, it tells that you have to have a पॉजिटिव ब्लड कल्चर, बेसिकली पॉजिटिव ब्लड कल्चर होना चाहिए आपके पास. ब्लड कल्चर में बैक्टीरिया पॉजिटिव होना चाहिए. एंड देन एविडेंस ऑफ इन्फेक्शन ऑफ द एंडोकार्डियम इन इकोकार्डियोग्राफी में आपको वेजिटेशंस मिलना चाहिए. वेजिटेशंस इन द हार्ट वाल्व्स, यू नीड टू गेट वेजिटेशंस. प्लस योर ब्लड कल्चर शुड बी पॉजिटिव. देर इज टाइमिंग कि आप 12 आवर में कितना सैंपल्स भेजोगे, 24 आवर्स में कितने सैंपल्स भेजोगे. दीज ऑल थिंग्स ड्यूक्स क्राइटेरिया इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड क्वेश्चंस कम. ट्राई टू रीड फ्रॉम योर मेडिसिन बुक्स. सो वंस पेशेंट का इन्फेक्टिव एंडोकार्डिटिस हो जाता है, दैट इज हार्ट में इन्फेक्शन हो जाता है ड्यूरिंग डिलीवरी, सो वॉट यू डू इज वी गिव इन्फेक्टिव एंडोकार्डिटिस प्रोफाइल एक्सेस टू द पेशेंट्स. That is every heart disease patient who delivers in our hospitals, we give antibiotics so that patient ka heart mein endocarditis infection na ho. So what are the antibiotics that are given? Ampicillin plus gentamicin. Ampicillin and gentamicin. Remember, this is the combination which is given. Gentamicin is given 80 milligram per kg. Okay, dose 8 hourly. Three doses are given 8 hourly, means 24 hours during the delivery ke 24 hours tak you give. And ampicillin is given 2 grams QID, just as in PPROM jaise dete hain, theek hai, for 4 doses in 24 hours. So ampicillin and gentamicin are the drugs which are given. Other than that, you can also give vancomycin if somebody is very much sensitive or very much allergic to ampicillin. You can give vancomycin also, or you can give ceftriaxone also to the patients. Ceftriaxone, these are the alternative drugs which are given, can be given. Okay, so this is all about infective endocarditis. Infective endocarditis, one more thing is, who are the candidates for IE prophylaxis? All patients are not given infective endocarditis prophylaxis. This is very important criteria. Please listen to this. So, patients who have prosthetic cardiac valves, matlab jinka artificial valves hain, they are more prone to infection during delivery. So, they are given infective endocarditis prophylaxis. Number two is, any previous history of infective endocarditis. Agar previously infective endocarditis hua hai, next previous pregnancy mein, to is baar dena hi hai. Next is, all the unrepaired congenital heart disease. Like unrepaired ASD, unrepaired VSD. Agar repair nahi hua hai, to unko zarur dena hai. Next hai, incompletely repaired, मतलब repaired तो हुआ है लेकिन properly नहीं हुआ है, कुछ residual disease रह गया है, residual ASD, VSD disease रह गया है, then also you will give infective endocarditis prophylaxis. Then comes patients who have the repair done within, repair has occurred in less than 6 months, मतलब अभी रिपेयर हुआ है 6 महीने के अंदर शी हैज़ बिकम प्रेग्नेंट एंड शी इज़ नाउ डिलीवरिंग, देन ऑल्सो यू हैव टू गिव इन्फेक्टिव एंडोकार्डाइटिस प्रोफाइलेक्सिस. एंड नंबर 6 इज कार्डियक ट्रांसप्लांट रेसिपियंट्स, जिनका ट्रांसप्लांटेड हार्ट है, कार्डियक ट्रांसप्लांट रेसिपियंट पेशेंट्स. ओके, दीज आर द 6 कैटेगरीज who are given infective endocarditis prophylaxis. Apart from that, no other patients are to be given infective endocarditis prophylaxis. So this is all about heart disease in pregnancy. I hope you have understood. If any doubt, any time, you can let me know. We can have more classes whereby we can talk about other minutest details from where questions can come. Thank you so much for listening.